welcome to an all-new Lay It On Me. Allow me to lay it on you. Hey guys, welcome to day 22 of Daily Uploads, where I upload every day for the rest of my life. We're at the home stretch, okay? I mean, technically, you know, 30 days isn't the end of my life. At least I'd like to hope that I live a little longer than that. But I guess what I mean is that we're at the home stretch for a huge landmark, which is a full month of daily uploads, which was secretly my own personal goal. So that's hype. Before I get into anything, I just have to say, you guys, okay? Yes, you watching, you guys are absolutely nuts. Like, guys, you're freaking insane, okay? And yesterday's video, I asked for you guys to subscribe because I'm trying to reach 200,000 subscribers by the end of the month. And within the first hour of the video, over 500 of you subscribed. What the heck, bro? It's been less than a day and somehow almost 2,000 of you guys subscribed in less than 24 hours, which is insane. You guys are crazy. I mean, technically at this rate, we could hit 200,000 by the end of the month, which was supposed to be unrealistic, like, and not possible. But I guess that's just what happens when you challenge the internet, I guess. So yeah, I just want to say thank you guys. I really appreciate this crazy wave of support. You guys are insane. Thank you so much. In order to thank you guys, I'm going to teach you guys in this video some tips about money, okay? I'm going to really tell you guys the secrets of money and how rich people stay rich and poor people stay poor. I'm an accountant, okay? So I'm gonna give you guys some insider secrets in this video, okay? You guys are going to love this, Maine. Speaking of Maine, yeah. Yesterday, Pokimane just went up and changed the entire Twitch game all in one tweet. Not an exaggeration, not clickbait, the Twitch streaming game has been challenged. Yesterday, she tweeted, "Worked with @Streamlabs to create a donation cap of $5 for my channel. Thank you for supporting me to the point where I consider anything more than that unnecessary. To anyone that was more generous, please support growing channels, charities, and treat yourselves. Red heart, smiling face with smiling eyes." Press F for all the tier 3 Pokimane simps who've been dropping $500 a day daily so that her queen can notice her. Now, this isn't the first time Pokimane has brought up this kind of sentiment. There was a clip of her recently where she basically like tells people to like stop giving her money. Oh, here we go. I'll just roll the clip.
That's a really good sound bit. If you ever want a free
coffee, Lamau. Aw, thank you. An amazing day. Thank you. Don't worry. Okay, I'm gonna be honest. Y'all need to stop giving people who got money free shit. Okay? Like, influencers, actors, people you recognize, they got money. You should say, hey, I'm a really big fan. And ask them to tip you extra.
So yeah, this is definitely a power play and one that could potentially have a snowball effect onto other streamers, which is why I say this is a game changer. This isn't just a tweet or, hey, this is a nice gesture. Okay, see ya. Like, there's a lot to unpack here, which is why I'm making this video in the first place. See, the thing here is that deliberately capping your income is the opposite of capitalism, okay? It's like saying, yo, look, I made it into the end game. I'm level 99, okay? I've got maxed out stats. I got all the items. I got all the armor, okay? There's nothing I can buy anymore. Go give it to someone else who needs it. And that way of thinking is pretty freaking cool. I don't know if you guys know this, but Pokimane went through this entire summer of scrutiny due to the whole Leafy situation. Rest in peace, Leafy. To the point where she took nearly a month off. Now, I don't know if she took the month off because of what was going on and maybe it was too stressful, or maybe she had it already had it planned. She got a lot of hate from all over the internet during that time. But I think it's important to give credit where credit is due. Now, I don't feel like we should be like worshiping her or something crazy, but yeah, I'm curious to see if the people who originally criticized her earlier in the summer are going to cover this topic, but I think it's good that we don't always talk about subjects where something bad happens to someone. You know, we need to kind of get the good in with the bad. So yeah. Anyway, let's talk about the ramifications, okay? You guys know we live in a society where the rich get richer and they stay rich by taking money constantly from the poor, right? Y'all know that, right? My viewers are educated. Y'all know what's up. I've been teaching y'all. To be frank, I don't think Pokimane had to do this, you know? Like, she's working, you know? She's streaming is her job, and part of that job is accepting tips from your viewers. Whatever money she gets while working is what she earned and what she's entitled to. No one is going to crucify her because the tier 3 simps were giving her a $10,000 weekly allowance in exchange for a smiley face emoji in the Discord DMs, you know? On top of this, she's not taking the money and donating it to charity. That's a big deal, okay? Now, you guys know I'm an accountant, so I'm going to educate you guys, okay? But you guys know that donating to charity is... it's a way for people to save their own money. You guys know that, right? If you didn't, let me enlighten some of you. It's called charitable contributions, okay? At the end of the year, Uncle Sam looks at how much money you made versus how much money you spent, and they calculate your net income. Then Uncle Sam takes that amount and multiplies it by a percentage and says, that is what you owe me, bitch. That's taxes, okay? However, you can lower your net income, which reduces how much Uncle Sam takes from you through a sequence of tax write-offs and deductions. That's where charitable tax deductions come into place. So let's let's make this easier for all of you guys. I'm just going to explain it to you like you guys are five, okay? Let's say you made a profit of $100,000 at the end of the year, okay? That's what you took back. That's essentially called your adjustable gross income, which is also known as AGI. Now, let's say you raised $60,000 for charity. Under the tax law, you can write off 50% of your AGI with charitable contributions, which means instead of getting taxed at $100,000, you'll be getting taxed at $50,000, okay? That's a lot of money you just saved. But thanks to the CARES Act this year, in 2020, you can write off 100% of your AGI, okay? If you guys don't know about the CARES Act, it's an act that was signed this year, you know, due to the pandemic, we're trying to help people and businesses get more money. So that means that we can write off 100% of our total AGI. That means if you made $100,000, you can give away $100,000 of charity money and your AGI is $0 and you don't owe taxes. You can even probably get a tax refund at that point. Now, it's a little bit more detailed than that, but are you guys getting it? Okay, am I waking you guys up? Okay, when I hold a fundraiser to give money to charity, you know, I am also using that money that the people have given me to lower the amount that I owe in taxes to the government, which I'm down for. Okay, I'd rather give money to charity than to the government any day. But what I'm trying to teach you guys is that giving money is a way rich people get more rich. Okay, you got it? All right, good. Lesson over. Now, let's pivot back to the subject, okay? Pokimane isn't suggesting that we raise money for charity either, but rather you save your money and spread it out to the rest of the creators. Obviously, that's not how it's going to play out in the end, you know? Like, if Pokimane was going to be gifted, like, I don't know, $500,000 in donations, and that number changed to now $100,000 because of this new, you know, Streamlabs cap, $400,000 of that money isn't suddenly going into everyone else's pockets automatically, you know? But it is available to be put into other people's pockets, and it's kept in the pockets of the donators themselves. And at this point, I just want to pause, okay, because I know I'm being a little bit nerdy here, okay? So if you're listening, I appreciate it. Like, this is the accounting side in me. I do like teaching my audience about how money works and how y'all can be saving money or be making money. So I like y'all to know how money works so y'all don't get swindled, you know, by the government or big businesses, okay? So this episode is kind of like a lesson in money for y'all. So, okay, all right, let's resume. So guys, what I'm saying is that the ramifications of what Pokimane is suggesting is huge, and we've defined that. What's more is that Pokimane is the number one female streamer on Twitch. This makes the move even more powerful because there is a chance that this move could influence other streamers who basically already won the endgame of life to follow suit. It does put a certain pressure, I would say. Not that other streamers have to do it, you know, I wouldn't penalize or criticize any content creator or streamer for not adopting or following suit here. Like I said before, they're earning their money by getting up every day and streaming and entertaining, okay? They're working. That's their job and that's their income. But because it's Pokimane who did this, this might create a conversation or a discussion for the rest of the top streamers, you know? Some of them might think, you know, I've got way too much money. I'm making money on sponsors and commercials and my gaming team and my YouTube and my investments. I'm making money in all of these sources. Perhaps I could also cap how much money I'm making by my audience who are donating to me. And when you think about it that way, it kind of makes sense. A lot of these guys are already like set for life and they're getting paid like buko amounts of money from a million and one other sources, usually some kind of other big business. And that big business isn't paying them based on how much donations they get. These businesses and sponsors and commercials are paying them based on their viewership, okay? If they bring in views, then that's how they get money. So at that point, why keep accepting $100+ donations for what could potentially be the lower and middle income class of people who are watching her for content creation? Do you guys see what I'm saying here and why this could be such a big deal? Like, the way I see it is like this, okay? We should be all working together to take money away from big business, okay? The 1% of the economy has made more money than some countries alone. It's ridiculous, okay? If we can create a system where we obtain more money from those people and also give less money to them as well, that's how you slowly spread out the wealth. I mean, imagine if Jeff Bezos or any other corporation was just like, all right, we're capping how much money we receive from like the lower middle income people, okay? We're putting a limit to it because we've made enough and we're making enough to continue to thrive. That kind of mindset being spread out throughout the entire economy, it would change everything forever. It doesn't remove the concept of capitalism. It just simply evens out the playing field a little bit more and it frees up how much available income and money is there to be given to other people who aren't rich. Anyway, that's all I have for this episode of Lay It On Me. You've just been laid. Moral of the story, Pokimane's decision is a vibe for 2020 that I can definitely stand behind. Anyway, let me know what you guys think about everything in the comments below, okay? I do want to say that there is a lot more to like donations and money and AGI and charity and net income. The things I mentioned are not 100% the way I explained, but it's to give you a general understanding of how it works. Going into the details of taxes and saving money and wealth distribution and how you can get more of it, we'd be here for many episodes, okay? Me giving you guys in-depth explanation of the tax laws is what actual tax advisors get paid for, so. So yeah, whenever there's a chance though for me to teach you guys more about making money or saving money, I'll definitely squeeze it into the videos. Hell, I guess if there's enough of a demand for it, I'll just make a video just telling you guys how to make more money. Do me a favor, I say this all the time, but if you enjoyed the video or if you made it to the end of the video, just please leave a like. It means the world to me. It lets me know that I made a decent video. And if you haven't already, drop that sub, okay, for more daily uploads. I hope you guys are enjoying the ride as much as I am. I'm a little nervous. I feel like I want to make sure this ride stays fun and enjoyable for everyone. And when more people come on board, I'm like, I'm not used to it. So I've been making content for a long time, okay? And many of my peers who have been making content for as long as I have are like way further along than me. So I'm not used to subscriber growth, okay? I'm not used to growing on YouTube. So it makes me nervous when there's a bunch of strangers who are saying, hey, just visited your channel and I like your stuff. Keep it up. I'm like, oh God, okay. But yeah, I just want to say I appreciate you guys. You guys are really making the full-time YouTube dream a reality. Anyway, regardless if we sink or swim, drink your water, okay? Whether you subscribe to me or not, if you don't drink your water, I'm gonna visit your house and untuck all your bed sheets and cut a hole in the big toe of all your socks. I'm hoping that by this time, you just hearing my voice is enough for you to be thirsty, so in more ways than one. Anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow. I love you guys. Have a great one and take care of yourselves.